could kiss you. I would love to kiss you. The price of kissing is your love. Now my loving is running toward my love.
Thank you. not the place to work, to read, write, or think. I should have remembered that from other years. One becomes like the element on which one lies, flattened by the sea, bare, open, erased by today's tides of all yesterday's scribblings. And then the mind wakes, begins to drift, to turn over in gentle, careless rolls like those lazy waves on the beach. One never knows what chance treasures these easy, unconscious rollers may toss up on the smooth white sand of the conscious mind. What perfectly rounded stone, what rare shell from the ocean floor, perhaps a channeled whelk, a moon shell, or even an argonaut. Patience is what the sea teaches, patience and faith. One should lie empty, open, choiceless as a beach, waiting for a gift from the sea. Deserted. It once housed a whelk, and then temporarily a little hermit crab who has run away, leaving his tracks behind him like a delicate vine on the sand. I too have run away. I have shed the shell of my life for these few weeks of vacation. His shell is simple, bare, beautiful. My shell is not like this. How untidy it has become. Blurred with moss, knobby with barnacles, its shape is hardly recognizable anymore. Surely it had a shape once. What is the shape of my life? Choose a simple shell I can carry easily, like a hermit crab. But I find that my frame of life does not foster simplicity. The life I have chosen as a wife and mother entrains a whole caravan of complications. It involves food and shelter, meals, marketing, bills, countless experts to keep my modern house functioning. It involves health, doctors, dentists, medicine, vitamins, trips to the drugstore, education, school conferences, carpools, basketball or orchestra practice, tutoring, camps, shopping, laundry, cleaning, mending. It involves friends, my husband's, my children's, my own, endless arrangements to get together, letters, invitations, telephone calls, transportation, hither and yon. What a circus act we women perform every day of our lives. Look at us. We run a tightrope daily, balancing a pile of books on the head, baby carriage, parasol, kitchen chair, still under control. Steady now.
Steady now.
What is the answer? I have only clues, shells from the sea. The bare beauty of the channeled wealth tells me that perhaps a first step is in simplification of life. My little channeled whelk will sit on my desk to remind me of the ideal of a simplified life, to ask how little, not how much, can I get along with, to say, is it necessary, when I am tempted to add one more accumulation to my life, when I am pulled toward one more activity. One is free, like the hermit crab, to change one's shell.
One is free, like the hermit crab, to change one's shell.
As a horse chestnut. Milky and opaque, it has the pinkish bloom of the sky on a summer evening, ripening to rain. On its smooth, symmetrical face is penciled with precision a perfect spiral, winding inward to the pinpoint center of the shell, the tiny dark core, the pupil of the eye. It stares at me, this mysterious single eye, and I stare back. Now it is the moon, solitary in the sky. Now it is an island set in ever-widening circles of waves, alone, self-contained, serene. How one hates to think of oneself as alone. How one avoids it. We seem so frightened today of being alone that we never let it happen. When the noise stops, there is no inner music to take its place. We must relearn to be alone. Only when one is connected to one's own core is one connected to others. And for me, the core, the inner spring, can best be refound through solitude.
Thank you.
give you another name, Island Shell. I cannot live forever on my island, but I can take you back to my desk. You will fasten your single eye upon me. You will say to me, solitude. You will remind me that unless I keep the island quality intact somewhere within me, I will have little to give my husband, my children, my friends, or the world at large. Paper nautilus who are not fastened to their shell at all. It is actually a cradle for the young, held in the arms of the mother argonaut who floats with it to the surface where the eggs hatch and the young swim away. Then the mother argonaut leaves her shell and starts another life. Lovely shell, lovely image. Is this the symbol for another stage in relationships? Can we argonauts look forward to the freedom of the nautilus who has left its shell for the open seas? Because they move confidently in the same pattern, intricate but free, like a country dance of Mozart, moving to the same rhythm and being invisibly nourished by it. Lightness of touch and living in the moment are intertwined. It is what William Blake was speaking of when he wrote, "He who bends to himself a joy doth the winged life destroy. But he who kisses the joy as it flies lives in eternity's sunrise." Destroy the winged life in each other or in themselves. The veritable life of our emotions and our relationships is intermittent. When you love someone, you do not love them all the time in exactly the same way from moment to moment. It is an impossibility. And yet this is exactly what most of us demand. We have so little faith in the ebb and flow of life, of love, of relationships. We leap at the flow of the tide and resist in terror its ebb. We are afraid it will never return. We insist on permanency when the only continuity possible is in growth, in freedom, in the sense that the dancers are free. Barely touching as they pass, but partners in the same pattern. Intermittency. How can one learn to live through the ebb tides of one's existence? Perhaps this is the most important thing for me to take back from beach living. Simply the memory that each cycle of the tide is valid. Each cycle of the wave is valid. Each cycle of a relationship is valid. And my shells, I can sweep them all into my pocket. They are there to remind me that the sea recedes and returns eternally. We find again some of the joy in the now, some of the peace in the here, some of the love in me and thee, which go up to make up the kingdom of heaven on earth. The waves echo behind me. Patience, faith, openness is what the sea has to teach. Simplicity, solitude, intermittency. But there are other beaches to explore. There are more shells to find. This is only a beginning. gift from the sea.